There are thousands of women like this in London who have no homes and cannot afford to rent a room. Women who have fallen on hard times, women whose marriages have broken up or who've been rejected by their families. They need a roof over their heads, and often emergency hostel accommodation turns into a stay of months or even years. The authors of A Guide to Hostels for Women in London, published today, believe that the problem of vagrant men is well recognised and catered for, but homeless women just aren't provided for. Sophie Watson is the co-author of Shack's Guide to Women's Hostels.
Well, the main problem is that women's homelessness tends to be very hidden, and traditionally the image of the homeless person is of the homeless man, the tramp, the sort of vagrant. And we felt it was very important to publicise the sorts of places that were available for women in London.
Are there plenty of homeless women in London, in fact?
Well, I think there are an enormous amount of homeless women in London. The problem is that because there are very few emergency hostels for women, people tend to think that there aren't very many homeless women around because they count the numbers of women in the hostels rather than recognise that it's a hidden problem.
What kind of women come to these hostels?
Well, there's a huge range of women, from young women leaving home looking for jobs or young working women to women in their late 50s whose marriages have broken up or who, for one reason or another, have lost their job and need somewhere to live.
Hostels can never be a permanent home, but they are a necessary stopgap measure for homeless women. It's hoped that by providing details of location, price and number of beds, plus some indication of what conditions are like in each hostel, the problem of homelessness amongst women in the capital will at least have been recognised. Jane Corbin for Thames News.